Houston for news. This is Channel 12 News, the 6 o'clock report with Eleanor Schano White.
Good evening, everyone. At least three people are dead, 30 more injured in the collapse of a condominium under construction in Cocoa Beach. Reports from the scene indicate 75 workers were trapped inside the four-story building when it collapsed. Sky 12 is on the scene at this hour. We'll have a complete report for you tonight at 11. Meanwhile, health officials in South Florida are concerned tonight about some outbreaks of typhoid occurring in Haitian refugees. The Disease Control Center in Atlanta has confirmed at least two cases in Miami. So far, none in our area. One other Haitian is suspected to have contacted the disease. Apparently, the three refugees came to Florida on the same boat last month. They've been staying at a Haitian center in Miami. Officials believe other Haitians on that boat may also get the disease. Meanwhile, Congressman Dan Mica was in town today talking about the newly formed Foreign Affairs Committee. Members plan to go to Haiti to study how $12 million in American aid is being spent.
Professionals to study the use of our aid there within the next two or three weeks, and this was just approved by the Foreign Affairs Committee yesterday. It will not be congressmen, it will not be private individuals, it will be people, professionals from the Foreign Affairs Committee. They'll go very quickly and come back with some analysis of the situation.
Mica also talked about finding a way to help CETA workers in Palm Beach County who are going to lose their jobs very soon. Stan Zimmerman has that story.
3 weeks and counting until 1,100 Palm Beach County CETA workers are out of a job. But help may be forthcoming from the private sector.
And I'm joining with the Economic Council of Palm Beach County, the Urban League, Pratt & Whitney, Florida Power & Light, the Chamber of Commerce, and trying to make this work locally without the government funds. So I think this will be a bit of a test here. I'm going to do all I can to try to make it work, and I hope the community will join together. I think it'll be a great plus for this community if we could say that we did not need these funds, we made it work, and we did it on our own with private sector funds.
Who organized this coalition?
I think it was kind of an idea that everyone had at the same time. I called the Economic Council and offered to be a coordinator and to help solicit in the community jobs. At the same time, the Urban League was contacting, I believe, Pratt & Whitney, and the county was contacting the Urban League. Apparently all came together with the same idea.
Mica considers the response of local employers a good test to see if the private sector can absorb and train the workers who formerly depended upon CETA for their jobs and training. Stan Zimmerman, 12 News, Palm Beach.
The Palm Beach County Hotel and Motel Association quietly pressured local legislators today to dump a pair of bills which would double the optional county resort tax.
One of the reasons we called this, too, is there were two bills that are being proposed possibly on the state level. One was the House Bill 70, which is involved with the present resort tax that has been passed by the state. But this would be an increase of another 2% to the existing 2% tax. And then also the PBC-2 bill also again affects another additional 2% on the resort tax.
Such a resort tax is currently under study in Palm Beach County, but must be approved by the voters in a referendum. The Citizens Transportation Board today outlined proposed cuts in the Co-Tran bus system. Under the plan, fares will go up 10 to 60 cents July 1st. Routes in Jupiter, Tequesta, Palm Beach Gardens, Boynton Beach, and Boca Raton will be cut. Also, the express bus to the Palm Beach Mall will be eliminated.
Well, the net effect could reduce our operating deficit about 30 to 36%.
CORE estimates they'll lose about 4% of the riders. Well, to no one's surprise, the state won't have enough money to satisfy all of Palm Beach County's road construction needs. That was the message from Secretary of Transportation Jake Barn today when he addressed a group of Palm Beach County businessmen. Barn said one big problem is deciding who should get what.
One of the things that I think would be very, very helpful to those of us involved in the process is if we could clearly delineate what the state's role in transportation was versus the county's role or local government's role was. I think it's pretty unclear as to what is the state's responsibility and what is local responsibility.
The secretary went on to say that only half of the state's bridge needs will be satisfied this year. Barn recommended counties build roads now, rather than wait for costs to soar. Coming up next, the countywide crackdown on pornography. The countywide crackdown on pornography continues tonight. Deputy DeSaul reports the state attorney's office finally made a public statement about the case.
I think the sense of the citizenry here is that this is a wonderful community, and they do not want to allow an unbridled presence of obscene materials.
The state attorney's office initiated the latest pornography crackdown in Palm Beach County, the first since 1977. David Bloodworth, in a press conference this morning, said there was a clear commitment from the community. Under the law, residents determine what is obscene. That public standard, so far defined by the grand jury, has found material in some of the county's adult bookstores to be obscene. The obscenity law, according to state attorney David Bloodworth, is clearly defined and has been upheld in Florida's courts.
In three opinions, our courts of Florida, the Supreme Court, in two opinions, has upheld the constitutionality of the obscenity statute of the state of Florida. So those lawyers and others who would tell you that it's still in flux, I would say that they should read the recent cases because it's been laid to rest in Florida. This statute is constitutional.
In the next few months, many juries will be deciding on the obscenity question, which in the past has been shot down by the First Amendment right to freedom of the press. Stephanie Stahl, 12 News, Palm Beach County.
Palm Beach Junior College Teachers Union has won a battle in its current war with the college. Hearing Officer Richard Donnellan of the Public Employees Relations Commission recommended the college's Board of Trustees withdraw a management rights clause from their latest contract offer. Donnellan said the clause was an attempt to interfere with public employees.
Good decision, and evidently the per hearing officer agrees with us that the management rights clause is unlawful. It should not be in the contract.
The commission, or PERC as it's called, now has 3 months to vote on the hearing officer's ruling, and there's a slight chance PERC will not agree with the recommendation.
We do this at times. As a matter of fact, this has happened one time previous in our negotiations here. But I believe that more often than not, the commission does rule with the hearing officer.
Both sides said this report will have no effect on the college's recent offer to teachers of a bonus and a 10% raise. About 100 people walked the Living Well Mile this afternoon in downtown West Palm Beach. March has been named the Living Well Month by Governor Bob Graham. This morning's event was organized to promote better health throughout our state.
This is what the health department and our health promotion program, Health Plus, is sponsoring as our little part in Living Well in Florida. It's to promote health and fitness and being outside, being active, and Florida is a wonderful place to be able to do this type of thing. We can be outside all year round.
The event was sponsored by Health Plus, a promotion program of the county health department. A major fueling test of the space shuttle ran into some trouble today at Cape Canaveral. A minor hydrogen leak caused a 3-hour delay in the fueling rehearsal. The loading of both liquid hydrogen and oxygen into the giant fuel tank is the latest big test before the launch early next month. The leak was fixed today. The test resumed without incident. Today's operation duplicates the same method which will be used on the day of the launch. And coming up next, the social event of the season. Stay tuned. Workers and volunteers at the Palm Beach Martin County Medical Center are gearing up for what they call the social event of the season. The annual Pink and White Ball will be held tomorrow night in a huge tent on the hospital grounds. The hospital says the 500 tickets have been sold out for a long time. The money raised from this year's event will go toward the medical center. Well, it's weather time, it's weekend time, and hopefully this adds up to those two beautiful words, sunny and warmer. Okay.
You have it. You read my forecast
somehow.
I know.
That's right. Dave Worth is up next, and he talks with the newest Brave. When State Attorney David Bloodworth wasn't cracking down on pornography today, he was making a pitch for a new campaign to prevent crime. And the slogan, well, it's definitely unique.
Crime prevention, ladies and gentlemen, is the key to long-term future. So I hope that you will publicize the efforts of these men and help us all take a bite out of crime for Palm Beach County.
That indeed is State Attorney David Bloodworth behind the dog mask. Now, you all get it, don't you? Put a bite on crime. It seems Mr. Bloodworth will go to any extreme to make a point. Some of his friends, though, well, they say he might even be barking up the wrong tree. And is a tough act to follow.
You're going to make me do it, though, I suppose.
Dave Wirth here for Jim Gallagher tonight. And, Dave, I understand that you talked to the newest big brave from Atlanta.
He worked out for the first time today. Glad to be here in West Palm Beach, too.
And both salt and freshwater fishermen should be doing very well. Ross Parsons says there are dolphin and snook to be had, and inland, the trout and big bass could make for a good catch. Hope you'll stay with us for a special walking tour of the sights and sounds of spring. No doubt about it, Palm Beach is easy to take, especially in the springtime and especially on Worth Avenue, one of the most famous shopping streets in the whole world. Well, today, 12 News photographer Phil Zeroni joined me for a very special visit, and we invite you to come along. According to Roman legend, Flora is the goddess of flowers, and the Esplanade here on Worth Avenue has entered into the true spirit of the season with its Floralia celebration. Here, all 40 shop owners have competed for the most beautiful, most unusual, and most whimsical use of fresh flowers. There are thousands of beautiful blooms and buds everywhere. Visitors entering the Esplanade through valet parking are greeted the rainbow of colorful Gerber daisies. And it's one charming window display after another. Two great purple turtles made out of over 1,000 pom-poms and daisies. Elsewhere throughout the courtyard, hanging baskets are just dripping with blossoms. Even a peacock of flowers in a men's store window, the tail of which is a display of colorful neckties. All in all, it's a flower lover's dream come true. And it's our tribute to you tonight as we celebrate the first full week of spring. That's the early edition of 12 News. ABC World News is up next. For Jim and Patty, the entire 12 News team, I'm Eleanor Schano White. Thanks for joining us, and have a good weekend, everyone.